The Black Barbershop. When you walk in and hear a barber say, "Hey, I got you," that can only mean one of two things. "Man, I got you," like, "I'll get you in and out of your seat in 10 minutes and out the door, I got you." Or it can mean like, "I got you," like, "I really got you. Don't even bother looking at a mirror because I'm going to spend my time and energy till you don't have any problems on your head and you can focus on the rest of your day." It's Joe's first time getting his hair cut by a black barber, and it's our date night, so I don't want anything in our way.
He can take it to that next level. Guaranteed my next level. My king's dreamer, give a nightmare to the devil. I'm set apart, not settling in this art. The Huxtables told me to be untouchable when I marked the page. I'm getting smart, I'm praising the Lord, not the stage. I'm gaining weight, I'm blaming good meals and my age and my beautiful wife and my lyrical life. It's funny cause I know gluttony is a spiritual fight. I'm following Christ, not these rappers and actors. I'm rolling with the breaks, y'all some hairline fractures. I'm sorry, this really just a scare tactic I use to try to prevent you from rapping, and that's really not cool. I just really wanna use a breakbeat to break a record in, to let my breaks heads know that they are respected in my view. I am well connected with my crew, but when they don't listen to me.
How I look? Do you like it? You like it?
Yeah.
Like, do you like it? You gonna wear it?
It looks sharper.
No, outlining thing where, like,
they sprayed the little black stuff in his hair.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they start digging into your digging into the lines right here, like.
Oh, you want to shape up?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what you call it. Is it a shape?
Yeah, shape up.
You ain't never had a shape up before?
Not like that.
Dang.
I mean, I had it like here, but not like up in the scalp.
Oh yeah, back, man, like, that's
back here.
All like, around, yeah. Hey, man, welcome to the club, bro.
And they sprayed the little black.
Yeah, they get the hair fiber.
Yeah, to make it darker. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh.
Yeah.
To make it look like I got a helmet on my head.
Remember we went to the prom and it had like all this right here. No. Like your hairline was fucked up. This was back here. And they put this black all over. And they took like a razor blade and they made it. When they took the picture, like the light and all that, it looked like it was his hairline, but it was like mascara. That one put under the eye.
Yeah.
It was that, and they took a razor blade and lined it up perfect. It was sharp. It looked better than my shape. It really did. And I said, you know what, man? I ain't been out in a long time. I'm just gonna go out and hang out. And so I came back. Oh, but I realized that I've been gone for so long. That, you know, I don't have nowhere to go. Like,
that's what we're doing. That's why when you ask me what are you doing on this side of town, I'm like,
I don't have no, like, I don't have the juice no more. Like, I used to have the juice. Like, I could be like, wow, and then like, it happened, or you know, we could have fun. But it's like, I'm Rod Brown. Like, I don't got the juice no more. I'm old. Like, this is a young game, man.
Oh,
I was telling my mom, like, I be going to sleep like 8, 9 o'clock. Man, and then Stephanie, she goes out with her sister.
Oh.
Don't tell me. So I'm trying one up her and she, like, yeah, I went out too. You know what I'm saying? Like, trying to be like, yeah, you know, I had a good time too. I ain't do shit. Like, you know what I mean? Just want to throw in it. You want to have something to throw in the face. You don't want to just be like, I was in the house all night. Nah, I was out too.
Let's go to the lounge. I want to see what the lounge is about. We have the time.
Should we take the toll?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Lead the way.
Next level, you won't believe my next level is even out of my league. My league should leave you with lesions. Even if you try to get even, you still be an odd.
I've been waiting so long to get alone time with Joe, but tonight all of our time went into trying to figure out what to do with our time. By the time we decided to go to a place that we heard about on the radio, we ended up getting there in its last hour and our night was over.
Since having our most recent child, we've had almost no quality time together. We've had to, like, figure out ways throughout the day to get back to each other. But unfortunately, just being in the same space, it doesn't necessarily mean that we have quality time, because there's a distinguishing difference between spending time with someone versus quality time. So spending time with someone is kind of like eating a snack. It's just enough to get by, and it might suffice for a little while, but it's not actually fulfilling. It leaves room for wanting more.
Go get your favorite book, okay?
Oh, Gawky eyes.
Look at Nemo's,
eyes.
What are those things called? What are these called?
Eyes.
What's another word for them?
Eyes.
But what else?
Eyes.
Can't remember what they're called.
Eyes.
Call? What are these called, Joe?
Eyes.
Noon.
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 Yeah, noon.
Noon.
The end. I'm gonna teach you how to skate, okay?
Okay.
It's like, how do I explain it?
It's not like rollerblading, I know.
No, it's not like rollerblading. It's like ice skating. Have you ever been ice skating before? Roller skating is the
same. I remember
same
going
as
ice skating when I was little.
Where is it? Right here?
I can't exactly remember exactly where it is.
Edition with pretty brown eyes. And you are listening to the LaDon Black Show on Magic 95.9. Tonight we are talking about those questions, those dumb questions that people ask you all the time when it comes to love, sex, and relationships. Talk to
what
me.
Questions are those?
The question is, you know, you first meet someone, they ask you what are your plans for the next 5 years, and you tell them, and it has nothing to do with them because you just met them, then they get pissed at you.
Oh my goodness, I know someone just like that.
Keep doing it. You have to keep doing it.
Like, I know how to rollerblade, but I don't know how to roller skate.
I hate riding with skates from here because they're not balanced properly.
Riding with skates?
You know, like easy skates. But they're not completely balanced properly. Here, we can skate together if we skate well.
But on the other hand, quality time to me is like a home-cooked meal. It's hearty and handmade, and when I'm having quality time with Elena, I feel cozy and comfortable with the time. I'm not really thinking about the kid's schedule or what I need to get done. I can be present with her, and this time that I have with her, it's more than enough.
You have fun, Joe?
Yeah, that's fun.
So you can't really just practice like on the street or like on a road because it's a different type of friction and stuff, right?
Like, I used to practice in my basement. That's one of the only places where it's permissible for two guys to touch hands with each other and dance with each other, basically. I mean, what it basically is one person is helping the other person to do the tricks. It's like a helper. Yeah. So they kind of like lead and guide you because some of the things need, you know, kind of like just need someone you to hold someone's hand to do.
Yeah. It's kind of like breakdancing where sometimes you grab the guy's hand so that they can do a flip or like they roll on your back or they hug you, they like straddle you on your back for someone else to do a trick.
Right, that's
We've been chasing this concept of quality time for so long that I feel like we're more about the chase for what it could be rather than actually being aware of what we have when we obtain it. But sometimes we have our moments and we realize what time it is. Sometimes it's time to be a parent. Sometimes it's time to be a friend. And sometimes it's that time.
Why are you looking at it like it's a foreign object?
I don't know, I've never seen this brand before.
It's a bottle of water. Joe, don't fall asleep.
I'm looking at the monitor.
Because I expect that tonight. I expect that long dong tonight.
Long dong?
I expect that good. No, so that good.
The Elmer's glue.
Ew, what the hell is that? I've never heard that before, and I do not want that. I do not want Elmer's glue.
You don't want the Elmer's glue?
No, I don't know what that is. I do not want that. That does not sound good. Toxic. That sounds toxic.
Toxic. It's non-toxic.
No.
It's kid-friendly.